I didn't even want to have to talk about this. I did not even want to have to talk about this. I already recorded and posted one video today. I did not want to have to do a second video. But between everybody in the comments last week talking about North Korea and the news that just came out an hour ago, I have to address this and address what the whole deal is here with North Korea. Are we about to go into World War III? Is the stock market going to crash because of whatever is going on? All this mumbo jumbo, guys. So this news just came out an hour ago about Kim Jong-un has reportedly received a plan to fire missiles toward Guam. Kim Jong-un has been briefed by his military on a plan to launch missiles toward U.S. territory of Guam, according to South Korea's Yonhap News, citing North Korean media reports. So let's take all this into account. First off, just because they got plans to do something does not mean they are going to fire missiles, okay? This Kim Jong-un, he wants more attention than the Kardashians want attention. Like, he has to be in the spotlight. He has to be in the spotlight all the time. He's getting exactly what he wants. The media talking about him. Hell, I'm making a video about him right now. He's getting exactly what he wants. He wants attention. The chances he's going to do anything as far as firing missiles toward Guam or trying to hit Guam or any U.S. territory, very slim. I would say under a 1% chance. He's crazy, but not that crazy. It's like a chihuahua that has a lot of bark, and then a big dog approaches it and gets up close, and then that chihuahua backs off, and it's like, I don't really want any of that. That is this guy. Now, let's say that 1% chance does happen, and he goes out, and he fires missiles toward Guam. Well, first off, those missiles are likely to be shot down. They're likely to be intercepted in the air and completely destroyed before they even get close to Guam. But let's say somehow he hits or gets even close to hitting, things like that. In my opinion, what the U.S. military would do at that point is they would go ahead and start attacking bases. They would not probably go after capital cities in North Korea or anything like that. They would probably strictly go after some of the bases and take out basically planes, take out missiles, all these type of things that are in North Korea, right? So that would be the plan. And then after that, that's probably going to be about it. I'll be honest, that'll probably be about it. North Korea would probably back up because the majority of their missiles and everything would be already taken out. Now, it's possible that he might want to pursue and go into a war or something at that point with whatever troops he wants and maybe try to, you know, go across the border of South Korea, things like that, and just, you know, go completely whack job in the head and, you know, just get his army absolutely slaughtered, right? That's absolutely a possibility. Very unlikely, very unlikely. But let's say that happens then. That happens. So now we got North Korea trying to invade South Korea. We got the United States here. We're obviously getting involved with that, even though it's nowhere close to the United States, right? Because we got to defend South Korea. We're boys with them, right? Then people worry about, oh, is it going to be World War III? Is China going to get involved at that point? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. The last country that China would ever want to go into war with is the United States, guys. You gotta understand this. You gotta understand the way the world works. The world is completely wrapped around money. It is completely wrapped around money. If you have the money, you have the power. If your government has the money, your government has the power. If you have the money, you have the biggest military, you have the biggest stick. That's the way the world works nowadays. Wars are won by money. Money, money. China and the United States are so intertwined as far as money goes that if one falters, the other falters. There's so many of our companies in the United States and in China that are so heavily reliant on the other country. I mean, if you took away the United States tomorrow, China's economy would be in shambles. There would be tens of millions of workers lose their jobs almost overnight, if not hundreds of millions, guys. So many jobs are supported in China, basically selling stuff here to the United States, and vice versa. We have tons of companies that make hundreds of millions of dollars, tens of millions of dollars, even billions of dollars of profit from China. China, guys. So China has absolutely no interest, and we don't even have to go into the fact that the United States owes massive amounts of debt to China, that China enjoys getting that money paid back to them if a war was to break out or something. Who knows? Those debts might just be canceled. The United States might be like, screw you guys. You try to, you know, attack us in this war, we're not going to pay your debts. And then, what, trillions of dollars just get wiped out overnight? Like, China does not want that at all, right? So China, hell no, they're not getting involved. The only way China would get involved if the United States wanted to attack them or something, probably unlikely, right, guys? So then you say, oh, will Russia get involved or something? Absolutely not. Russia wants no part of this. Russia does not want any part of getting involved in a North Korea slash United States slash South Korea war. Russia has no reason to get involved. Russia, if United States did something against Russia directly or something, absolutely Russia would probably attack back. And then you got a big mess. But the United States has no interest in doing that. Russia has really no interest of doing that. So the whole, oh, is this going to break into World War III? Like, you're talking about, yeah, all things in life are possible, but you're talking about a 0.0001% chance. So the question is, you know, how does all this affect the stock market, which is kind of, you know, what this channel is based upon, of the stock market and entrepreneurship, right? So how does all this affect the stock market? Doesn't really affect it very much. I mean, if a war with North Korea actually broke out, guys, it would probably affect the stock market. If North Korea actually connected on missiles toward Guam or even fired toward Guam, I think the stock market would go down. Not like 10% in a day or something like that. Not like a disaster, but the stock market probably would go down in the short term if something like that actually happened. But you got to understand, the markets are so far away from whatever happens out there. I mean, it used to be like if a terrorist attack happened, the markets got nailed that day. Now terrorist attacks happen all the time, and the markets do nothing. The day after the Manchester bombing out of the Ariana Grande's concert, the markets went up, guys. The stock markets went up the next day. Even the European exchanges. That's how different the stock market is nowadays compared to what it was in the past. This is just a norm. You know, terrorist threats, countries doing this, you know, people doing that, whatever. That's just a norm, guys. It's just the norm nowadays. The stock market doesn't freak out unless it's something really, really, really huge. And so if you're, don't get caught up in, let's say the stock market goes down tomorrow on, you know, and it's after this news has come out or whatever. Let's say the stock market goes down. It doesn't mean the stock market just went down because of North Korea did this or North Korea did that. It could just be because it happened to go down, guys. You got to understand, every single day the markets happen to go up or down for no reason at all. Just they happen to do that, guys. Could have absolutely nothing to do with that. The Chinese numbers came out last night. The Chinese economic numbers, they completely missed analyst forecasts across the board. They were still phenomenal, don't get me wrong, but they missed analyst expectations across the board, the Chinese economic numbers. And what happened in all the markets? They all flew up. Here in the United States, our markets went up like crazy today. So don't get caught up in if this happens, the market goes down, or it's because of this situation. Not necessarily. Sometimes it's just because of, you know, luck or whatever. So like I said, to cap off, North Korea is probably never going to fire those missiles toward Guam. If they do, they'll probably be intercepted, and you know their bases will probably be taken out at that point. If I was the president, if I was in charge of the military in the United States, if they even close to hit Guam, I would absolutely, without question, take out every single military base. I would have flyovers. I would do whatever it took to take out every single military base in North Korea within hopefully a 24-hour span, if not a 12-hour span. And then if they want to try to go after that, then let's go. You know, let's go ahead and bring it on if you're really that tough and you really are that crazy in the head that you want to go. But you're not going to fire at us and get away with it. So we shall see what happens with all this, guys. But I had to give my two cents on it because you guys, like in the comments section last week, it was like, North Korea, oh, this North Korea situation is getting worse. What's your take on North Korea? How's this going to affect the stock market? Kim Jong-un did this, whatever. So, you know, take it for what it is, guys. I hope you enjoyed this, and let's get back to regular videos starting tomorrow. Thank you for watching, guys, and have a great day.